Yeah, they're very happy to use a buyback if they think it'll win them the game. Sometimes you saw it game one versus the Pain Gaming when they lost. It's like, you know, sometimes they're a bit too liberal with it, but the fact they're not afraid to use them, I think, is a good sign to have in your team and players, particularly with the buyback changes.
I really like Ramsey's choice of items here. I think this was definitely an early Radiance game where when you already feel very countered against this Razor and then you're going into a Tide and Dragonite, it was naturally going to be a hard game for a Lifestealer, especially early on. So he gets this Radiance. He gets this really good timing where he's still effective once he does have that and that initial mid-engagement. They win a big fight there. And then from there on out, he's going to be out-farming everybody else in the map and no counter to a Rage TP, so he can play that kind of super aggro style where he's just shoving down lanes just like the Darkseer is.
Yep, I totally agree, Cap. And meanwhile, I did not like newbie's itemization. Drums, BKB on both DK, Razor, they already have damage problems and they're going this very like early fight type build. They don't farm fast, they don't get any damage out of these heroes. At no point did DK, Razor really look like a threat this game.
Yeah, and they went pipe on Tide, which is nice when you hit the timing against the Lifestealer Radiance, but VP's not dumb. They're not going to just run at you. Like, you have no damage, you have no real ability to scale, partly due to the itemization, partly because they have three, like, watermelons, and you're just, like, walking around, and they just don't five-man. Like, you're not going to get five-man.